Me
shoot things.
Yeah.
Me not light Africans.
Oh, I...
Me shoot Africans.
I'm equal opportunity. It depends on what... I don't shoot people.
You guys are talking about the league. Yeah. So is that a good show?
The first three seasons are golden.
Is it? Asa?
I like it. I'm not even that
better than It's Always Sunny?
No. Absolutely
no.
Not.
No.
Okay. It's the same kind of format where they're like, hey, it's a bunch of narcissistic sociopaths that are interacting with each other.
Without a bar, though.
It replaced a bar.
There actually are a few bars.
Replace owning a bar with compete in a fantasy football league. Hence the name.
The league.
And they get a lot of pro football players on there, yeah. Which I like a lot.
From the heart of Broadway. I'm not going to do my intro. I've been recording it. This is because you guys jibber-jab. Hey, fans. It's everything you come to expect and more from Podzilla 1985 with your host... Myself, Shannon Young, with me tonight for this special show dedicated to the memory of Dave Mahoney, Asa Gray. Asa. Hi.
Rest in power.
Rest in prison.
All right. R.I.P. in peace.
Wait, did he actually go to prison?
Not yet. I mean, who knows at this point?
I was wondering if there had been an update, because last I heard he was just going to have to pay a big fine.
And I hope that's what it is. If you fans don't know what the story is behind that, go ask CJ.
Jesse related, Kimball. I need to make a phone call.
The ratings board.
Inside jokes.
What's bad is CJ might actually listen to this show, and then he's going to get really upset.
No, he won't. You know he won't listen to
well,
this show.
Well, this is guns. He might be interested in
that. He does like guns, yeah. Jesse Kimball's here.
Hey.
He almost wasn't.
That's true. There's a big misunderstanding. Let's move on. Hey, Michael.
Michael Branum.
What the? Knew.
Yes, from Multipixel.
Yeah.
Subsidiary of Crystal Francis Productions, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
And my channel that I haven't posted on in like 6 months.
Now, what's your channel?
Hey, I play games and do stuff.
It's
a super long name.
I just wanted to hear the
tag. I play games and do stuff.
Now, yeah. Jesse's looking at you there. You record.
I do, but I'm used to my microphone that picks up everything.
He's got a Yeti.
Yeah.
I know he does.
Yeah.
I like it.
That's what Lindsay says I've got.
Is this Tanner Thursday now?
Woo! Sorry.
It must be Tanner Thursday because he's not here. You hillbilly motherfucker!
Oh, God. That was too much.
That bomb's already.
Too mean.
Let's go over what happened today. Let's discuss what happened. Before we get into the show, we're talking about gun control tonight. It's a hot topic. I can't stop saying about
it's
always sunny.
The gang solves the gun crisis.
Yes.
But before that, let's talk about the new Podzilla 1985 Facebook page. Which replaces the old Podzilla 1985 Facebook page, which was under the banner Blogzilla 1985 because it was a blanket corporation like Wolf Cola.
Yes. Delicious, refreshing Wolf Cola.
For any occasion. Tanner took it upon himself today to create a new Podzilla Facebook page.
Yes.
And he said, well, we've got people on there that didn't like the previous one. We've got new people added to it. And my thought process was, well, why don't you just promote the one we've already got and then we'll have even more? Because the 40 people that signed up today is less than the 110 that's already signed up to the other one.
I mean, to be fair, I think it's actually up like over 50 now.
Those are numbers.
Let me know when it's over 9,000.
That's
you
for
know
Zach. I will.
That's a reference.
Yeah. Speaking of that, let's talk about that for a second. So, did you see the post today about Ronda Rousey dressed up as Sailor Moon? Yeah.
Oh. Well, that, I saw that one too, but there was a much more big news thing with Ronda Rousey today.
Oh, what did she do?
Did you not hear about the Marine thing?
Oh, she accepted it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I would rather
see us dressed
that,
up as Sailor Moon.
The dude has to find dates for her three friends.
Yeah. Oh, the four horsewomen?
Yes, the four horsewomen are going to the Marine Ball in North Carolina.
Never have there been more attractive women that were labeled as horsewomen. Since Sarah Jessica Parker. Because she looks like a horse face. What are you looking up now? I forget.
How many people?
I was trying to see. I was wrong.
Don't give out too many secrets on there.
It's at 45.
45. Ooh. Hey, you know what 45 is as well? A gun.
That's true. What a segue.
What a great transition.
Caliber.
Seamless.
Caliber.
It is a caliber bullet.
We didn't even talk about Ronda Rousey and Sailor Moon, but it's fine. It's fine. No, it's fine.
Hot,
I don't want to talk about
me.
It. Yeah.
Without using a gun.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Let's be honest. Let's break it down real quick. Ronda Rousey is attractive, but she's not a supermodel. Everyone keeps going on and on about how smoking hot she is. She's very attractive, but she's not the hottest thing in the world. Stop acting like she's, you know,
personality goes a long way.
Yeah.
Her personality is that she beats the shit out of men.
Well,
and is a nerd.
In bed.
And is a nerd. Yeah.
And that's why she's the internet's darling.
Okay,
and
I give it to
about,
you.
And her candidness, too. I don't know. There's something about, like...
She's very open. She's very...
Very open.
She's very Ronda Rousey.
Right.
Yeah.
She's like if Jennifer Lawrence could beat people up.
Yeah.
See,
that's a good...
So Ronda Rousey has just cabinets full of naked pictures of herself?
Yes.
like Jennifer Lawrence?
Well, I mean, ESPN, they're in a swimsuit issue.
She's in the body issue.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
She was very naked in
she
it.
She was very naked.
I didn't even realize who she was at the time.
There was no nip-nops, right?
But no, there's no...
Because it was Sports Illustrated.
Scron's getting excited over here.
I'm not Scron. You know this.
Steven is Scron. He also won't listen to this.
I really missed something with Scron. Like, they've been talking about it all night.
So did Krista from what I hear.
Oh,
shit!
Speaking of shots fired and segues into guns.
It's been a great show. You guys have fun.
That's okay. Krista doesn't listen to this show either.
Goddamn.
But boy, oh boy, if she did.
Wait, how many
or if she listened to the Pro Wrestling Unscripted show.
Oh, I listened to that today,
actually.
Was that
called her a cunt?
Oh! What?
Yeah, there's sort of misunderstanding. He believes that Krista was trying to tell people to stomp on his puppy.
Don't stomp on puppies.
Obviously don't stomp on puppies, people.
I mean, Krista never said that. Krista doesn't like puppies, and she didn't want to hold the puppy, but she didn't say murder the puppy.
But Krista is an animal lover.
Yeah.
So there's no... Well, I'm sure she likes animals in general.
Cats. I had her...
She would wish no harm on a puppy.
Correct.
She likes cats.
I had pulled up a video of a husky, baby husky, learning how to howl, and she made dull sounds about it. There is a witness. She does like puppies.
No, it's very rare for her to like a puppy. Very rare.
It was the husky puppy. That's what did it. And it was howling.
You know, I had a husky when I was younger. And it wrapped its chain around my head and tried to kill me.
Did you deserve it?
Yes.
Okay.
Ironically, later I grew up to be husky.
I see what you did there. He couldn't even get that one finished. Worse than Jimmy Fallon.
That's because it wasn't a pizza. Oh, my God.
What is happening?
What is happening? It's open mic night at Godzilla 1985. Someone needs to close it.
Guns?
Guns.
Guns.
Come on, conductor.
Isn't tonight Tuesday? Is this supposed to be serious?
Yeah.
Oh, do we need
just redo it. Redo the whole show.
We need to go into WWE announcer mode. It's very somber.
We're here.
Byron Saxton out here.
Well, we want people to listen.
Oh, by the way, we'll talk about this more on this Friday's Pro Wrestling. Did you hear about Jimmy Snuka?
Yeah.
Finally charged with the murder of his girlfriend from 1983.
Oh,
I was about to say over 30 years ago.
And there's a real solid chance that Vince McMahon's going to get brought into this because
he's the one that cock-blocked him originally and wouldn't let them talk to him.
Because he said that he didn't speak English.
Yeah.
Really?
So McMahon could see some real trouble from this. But
which, apparently, the statute of limitations for obstruction of justice is expired, so he wouldn't actually face any jail time.
But it could tarnish him
forever. But, I mean, look what happened to Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
He may be
so he's going to blacklist himself from WWE.
I mean, he may not be blacklisted, but he'll the board of directors may require him to step down as any active.
I mean, yeah, bad things could happen from this. It'll be interesting to see what happens.
And then they'll hire Dana White. I hear he's great at
Dana White's a son of a bitch. No, all right, let's switch gears. Let's get serious. This is a serious topic. Now we're talking about guns. Why are we talking about guns? I'm doing hand gestures that no one in the audience can see.
Bang, bang, bang.
I shot all of you. If you watched the internet last week, and we know you do because you're listening to the show, and the show is not on television.
Yet.
TVzilla.
It's make a Facebook page.
God damn it!
Serious!
If you watched it last week, you saw what happened with Alison Parker and Adam Ward, gunned down live on television by a former employee of WDBJ, I think it is. Or BDJ, it's one of the two. And it just got me thinking about guns. I just started thinking about guns. I feel like D and Dennis's inaugural.
Are you going to make it there?
I feel like I'm high. But I don't know what that feels like. Yeah, well, it's been a weird day. But yeah, so.
Spend too much time around Kyrgyz today.
Do I have something on my nose?
It's you got a little bit of white there.
Inside jokes. what were we talking about?
Guns.
Mm-hmm. Guns.
You were trying to say inaugural.
Inaugural. Like their inaugural podcast. Once you start talking about something, you kind of lose. AC, you have this problem of losing track of thoughts. Yeah. But yeah, we're talking about guns because guns is, you put that up there with, religion and politics as like the serious topics that no one wants to talk about because everybody fights over it.
It's a hot button issue.
It's hot button and it's still hot, you know. Unfortunately, we could not get anybody on the show tonight that is extreme. The most extreme one we have here is Michael, I think. And,
well, I mean, I like guns.
Well, who doesn't?
They're fun.
Guns make you feel powerful.
You're not wrong.
Yeah.
When you're holding a gun, you know what it's like to feel like if you were God who was holding a gun.
What's the line from that one movie? It's like having two dicks.
But why? What is our obsession with guns in America?
I don't know, honestly, like, I also own a firearm.
Lots of people own firearms.
Yeah. Yeah.
I do not.
I have mine mostly for protection. It very rarely leaves the house. It stays in a location near the door. So I can grab it if need be. But I've taken it to the range a few times, and it's fun to shoot.
It is. But you have a handgun.
Yes.
You do not have an AR-15.
Accurate.
Michael. Do you have an
AR-15? I don't, but I'd actually like one, but I don't want to pay for one because guns are expensive.
Why do you need an AR-15?
Well, you don't need it. You might want it. There's a lot of things. I mean, that's a need and want thing. But
you're talking about an AR-15 like it's the newest Madden. It's not something that you just buy, just like, I feel like going out and getting an assault rifle today.
I hate that term assault rifle because, I mean, that is what an AR-15 is. That is exactly what it is.
And you realize what guns were made for.
They're made for shooting things.
For shooting.
Usually things you don't want to move anymore.
No one builds an AR-15 to go to the range to shoot cans.
Some people do. There's three-gun competitions that's nationally accepted. You know, people go professionally shoot things. But, but that's not everybody. That's not why most people have them.
That's not me.
That's not
my America.
That's America.
I mean, it's kind of like, how Terrence owns a competitive arcade fight stick cabinet thing?
But
Is he using the store?
Yeah, I'm aware of what you mean.
Well, okay, the point I was going to make is he's obviously never going to compete in any actual tournament. But he has one.
It would be much harder for someone that's lost his marbles to use an arcade fight stick to kill people.
I'm not saying.
Well, I'm just saying.
How big is it?
It's actually pretty big.
It is really big.
It's got some hits too.
But what I'm saying is, like, you know, people want the AR-15 and they go out target shooting, and you know they may not necessarily actually do competitive stuff, but they feel like they can because they're out there. They're hitting the cans.
Well, and also, I don't like the argument like that, people can use it competitively. People stack cups competitively.
Yes, they do.
Just because something can be turned into a competition doesn't necessarily mean it needs to be turned into a competition.
True.
I'm very torn on guns. I've always hated guns in a lot of ways. I've always thought they were unnecessary. I mean, I know they're necessary. A lot of people use them for protection. A lot of people use them for protection. A lot of people use them to hurt people. Gun violence in America has skyrocketed, or at least the ones you hear about, whether or not it's true or it's just the media facilitating a false sense of danger. But either way, it's in the news. It's headlining. Just Alison Parker and Adam Ward gunned down live television by a guy that bought the pistol legally. This was not a backdoor shenanigans type deal. He bought it legally, passed all the checks. The officer in Texas, pumping his gas, guy walks up behind him, puts 15 rounds in him on the spot, drops him dead. Mm-hmm. Guns, I mean, But what do you say about it? I don't know. I don't even know what to say about the subject.
Well, like, the argument for it is because it's people will, and a lot of people misinterpret the Second Amendment right to bear arms, which that's just the first part of that. It's the right to bear arms and form a militia.
Form a militia.
So if, you know, a threat to the United States or your homestead comes through, you are, you know, constitutionally allowed to be able to own a firearm to be able to protect yourself.
And now, times were different.
A lot
then.
Of these people, exact times were very different.
Very,
then.
Yeah. Very different.
A lot of these people claiming their Second Amendment rights are being taken away or falsely saying that, you know, oh, here's another thing that Obama's going to use to take our guns away,
Obama.
Even though
sorry.
He's literally said, like, especially after I think it was the Sandy Hook one.
Yeah.
He literally said, this is not the time to discuss this. This is a time for grieving.
Right.
Well,
you know,
and then everyone's like, oh, well, he said he's going to take them away. But, like, there's a lot of the people who are like, oh, I'd like to see him try to come and take my guns. Like, the people who are super,
they've
like,
militarized themselves. Yeah.
But right. What they don't understand is, okay, say the government organizes and says, you know what? We're taking all the guns. And they say, okay, come and get them. Who do they think they're going to be fighting? Are they expecting Obama and Biden to come door to door personally?
Dressed in the
no,
American flag.
It's going to be the military.
Soldiers.
The U.S. soldiers is who they're going to end up turning against when they so proudly state that, you know, pry it from my cold, dead hand.
Yeah, don't tread on me,
Bobby.
Bro.
Come and take it. Yeah.
I really hate that. People always say, well, they're going to use the newest, and I posted this on Facebook, they're going to use the newest shooting as grounds to take our guns away, or they're going to use this to push the agenda. And it struck me as, like, with all the shootings that are happening, there needs to be an agenda. There should be an agenda on getting guns off the street, because clearly what we have in place right now is not working. If it was working, there wouldn't be people dying every week on the news.
One of my favorite Onion headlines was after the Sandy Hook shooting, and it was, only country this type of event happens, shocked by this event.
Yeah, I remember seeing that one. And that hits the nail on the head for a lot of this stuff, because as in favor of firearms, as I am, I'm a big fan of responsible gun ownership.
Yeah.
But you can look into states where there are very rigorous gun laws, Illinois, but they also have a very high gun crime rate.
I was about to say Illinois.
Chicago
is, alone.
Chicago.
Yeah.
Is,
I'm actually looking at the stats right now for Chicago. Let's see here.
Yeah, and I lived in Southern Illinois for most of my life. I had a FOID card, which is the firearm owner, Illinois, whatever. You have to
identification
be,
card.
Thank you. I don't let her. But that's proof that it's kind of like the whole, well, meth's illegal, but they're getting that anyways.
Yeah. Looking at this, they said so far this year, Chicago police have taken almost 5,000 guns off the street.
And that's just a...
And Chicago is still every weekend. Yeah,
that's
gun
a staggering
killings.
Number.
So what do you do in a situation like that? How do you solve the gun crisis? Is there a way to solve the gun crisis? I mean, personally... go ahead, Asa.
Well, I mean, at this point, realistically, I don't think that there is a... just clean way of doing it.
No.
Everyone always assumes it's an either or situation and there's no in between. Overall, I support owning guns. I own a firearm. Like, it's something that, you know, you don't necessarily, but again, you don't need that AR-15.
No.
Like, there's
well,
no-
shit, you might in the future.
Guns
are getting more extreme.
But so, like, to me, it's not an either or. I think there should be really, there needs to be a lot more testing to do to be able to purchase a gun. Like, it's not just a pass a background check.
Make
here's
sure
your driver's license.
Yeah.
Which even those tests are lacking.
Well, yeah, look at the guy that shot Bryce Williams, I think is his name, or that's the name he went by, passed all the background checks, but had a history of mental instability, fired from multiple places for his behavior, purchased the gun just fine.
Yeah.
Well, Carolina shooting, the church shooting, he got acquired.
Dylan, well, I know we said we wouldn't say his name. Dylan Roof, we'll just say it once. Yeah. And, you know, the guy that shot the cameraman and the reporter actually said that he bought the gun right after that happened because he wanted to help start the race war. He said, you want a race war? You've got it.
Mm-hmm.
But in reality, he shot them in revenge because took his job.
Yeah.
Jesse, what do you think? What's the answer? Do you have an answer?
Man, I don't. There does need to be some sort of, like, middle ground, because I agree with Asa. You can't just say, like, everybody gets guns or nobody gets guns. Like, I don't agree with the fact that people can buy high-powered rifles, like an AR-15.
In Walmart.
It's yeah,
Walmart's
like
taking them off the shelves.
They are taking them off shelves, but not due to safety concerns. It's due to slumping sales.
Right.
So don't let Walmart spin it to you that they're concerned about safety. They took it down because it wasn't selling as well.
Because there needs to be like regulations on what kind of rifles you can purchase. Because obviously there's hunting. That's fine. You can buy hunting rifles. An AR-15 is not a hunting rifle.
But you can legally use it to hunt.
That's to hunt today's super animals.
But it's not designed that way. Like, it's not designed for that.
Plus, can you imagine what would happen to whatever you shot with an AR-15?
It's a small caliber. The 5.56 is a small caliber round. I mean...
Yeah, but it balloons.
It does, but then, like, a 308 bolt-action rifle does... I mean, you can use that for hunting also, and that is a lot larger caliber,
well,
moving
true,
a lot higher velocity.
But it doesn't balloon.
It doesn't balloon. It's a wounding round.
Officer, right. I feared for my life that deer... Was
it was coming right for me.
Yeah, no, it's, I don't know. I don't like the idea that you can buy certain kinds of guns, like.
Well, it's not even just at Walmart. Like, sure, the 18-year-old working the gun desk is the one running your background check and making sure you're not crazy, mm-hmm. but at how many events a year at the Show Me Center and at the Arena building?
Oh, the gun shows.
The gun shows. Where that's literally just, hey, I got $20, give me that pistol. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, that's actually where I got my firearm. I got it used at the gun show, and it took me all of 15 minutes to get the gun.
Or, hey, I have this shotgun. I want to trade it for your shotgun.
And, yeah, not counting the parking lot trades that happen at gun shows. There's
people out there just doing backdoor, back and forth. Well, see, I think that's what the problem is myself. I don't necessarily blame guns, because the old argument is true. Guns are inherently neither evil nor good. It's all up to who's using them, clearly. It's a tool. It's the culture that needs to change.
Yes.
The culture is the problem. The fact that we look at guns the way we do, and I don't want to sound like, you know, when you're young and everyone's always talking about, in their day, it wasn't like this, and then the music today and the movies today, it's influencing. And back then, I would say you're crazy. I'm normal. I never shot anybody or whatever, but it's hard to say with a straight face that movies, music, and video games have no effect on the youth of today. Clearly it does, because they are acting out the things they see, and that's the parents' fault, yes, but it's happening.
I more think that that's been a snowball effect. I think that has less to do with the media itself, and this has been just one of my little theories for a long time, but basically, gun violence started, and then they were, like, the response to gun violence is gun violence, and the response to gun violence is gun violence.
Escalation. Yeah.
So basically, it's just escalated, and I think it happens to, I think the media is more based on the actual escalation of gun violence than gun violence being based on media or TV shows, movies, etc.
And I think you're right when you say it's a culture thing, because this is what I told Michael, like, I'm going to kind of use this to sabotage the show for a minute. We need to not focus so much on who can buy what gun, especially considering, like, if someone fails a background check, like, oh, you have a mental illness, you can't buy this. What happens then? They just go back to their life, and they go somewhere else to try to purchase a gun. They may go to a gun show where they don't do as rigorous background checks or something.
Or just buy it off the street.
What we need is an absolute, complete reformation of how we deal with mental health in this country.
Oh, because absolutely.
Because there is when you go through and look at all of these, like, mass shootings, many, many, many of these people are mentally unstable. And sure, we can, like, we like to be able to just say, well, this person was just evil, this person was just a petty dick. Mm-hmm. These are, like, actual deep-seated mental illnesses that are left festering and gone untreated because the public school system doesn't identify it, because they're just worried about making sure they keep their funding and passing people. Like, there's just such a fundamental problem with it.
I can't think of a single person. I didn't mean to cut you off there, but the thought hit me. I can't think of a single shooting lately that's happened that the person that did the shooting wasn't mentally ill in one way or another. Even the cop that got shot down in Texas, that the guy shot him 15 times, that guy has been in and out. He is mentally unstable. How he got a gun, I don't know. I need to look into that. But yeah, you're absolutely right. We need to reevaluate the way we deal with people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, I said this before the show, if I had my way, and if it would actually happen, I would eliminate all guns from the planet. Mm-hmm. I would get rid of them. I've always, and I joked about this, and that will never happen, by the way.
Right.
The old argument that you take the guns away, only the bad people will have guns, that's true in a lot of ways. Mm-hmm.
Because but that's true about literally everything, though.
Yeah.
You make meth illegal, only criminals will have the illegal thing because it's illegal to have it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So just by definition, so I don't like that argument, though.
Well, I don't either, but I think it's true. I think
right, it's the best kind of right.
If they stop selling guns, completely.
Mm-hmm.
If they stop selling guns, I mean, yeah, people will still get them, good and bad, but, I mean, it's like that Simpsons episode where Homer wished away all weapons.
Oh, that's not
They'll just be chasing, niggas be chasing each other with boards with nails in them.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Everything's a weapon.
They they just burn them in a pile, don't they? And then that's when the aliens invade?
Yeah, and then they're that was Family Guy, wasn't it?
Family Guy.
Yeah. The Simpsons one is the... Oh, shit.
No, it was I thought it was a Treehouse of Horror. It was Treehouse of Horror. They burn all the guns, and, like, there's a giant pile.
And they're sitting around them, yeah.
And then the aliens invade, and so Mo has, like, the 2x4 with a nail sticking through it.
And then someday they'll build a 2x4 with a nail so big that it'll eliminate them all. Yeah, it'll never happen. You'll never get rid of guns. People love them too much. And I always said, how... Not cool, but if we went back to a medieval society...
I've also always thought.
Have you thought about that?
Because
nobody wants to get face to face with a sword and fight it out. No, no, no. It's much easier to stand back like a coward and shoot someone
with a crossbow.
And plus, like
that's why they have chainmail.
Repeating exactly. I mean, like people like me and Shannon would be just like we'd
do well.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm small. I am not. Scrawn's
not going to make it.
I'd be like, come here, twink.
We'd be lords on the battlefield. Oh, swinging our large axes and hammers around the battlefield.
The world would be a much different place if that is how people saw violence, was in your face, gory and bloody, not shooting.
And imagine if this guy had ran up on the cameraman and the reporter with a sword. Do you think they both would have died still?
No. And you know, some people...
It's tough.
Do
you think one of them could have gotten away?
How sharp
is
the sword?
Because the sword's not going. How fast does a bullet travel?
Well, the thing is,
I had
like,
the number
in
my.
Well, like, did you watch the video?
No, I did not because I do not like. Don't have any interest in seeing.
Basically,
that kind of stuff.
The scenario that played out, they would have died to a sword.
They locked up
because they weren't paying attention.
Mm-hmm. Like the dude was literally, she wasn't looking at him. Mm-hmm. He was sitting there waiting for the camera to turn back around with a gun about this distance. Well, maybe not quite this distance. About this distance away. And just waving the gun in his little GoPro camera.
Yeah.
And, like, just waiting for the camera to pan back around to her before he opened
fire. It was an execution, is what it was.
Yeah. So,
a random shooting.
He very easily could have killed him with a sword from that distance as well.
People make that argument all the time, too, about guns. I've always heard, if it's not guns, it's something else. If people aren't killing each other with guns, they'll have the board with the nail in it. They'll have a knife. They'll have a sword.
A freaking pin.
A pin. And, yes, that is true. You can kill people with just about anything if you're good enough.
But it's super easy to kill someone with a gun.
It's super
easy.
If a guy walks into a school with an AR-15, how many people do you think he's going to kill versus how many people would he kill with a pin?
Numbers.
That's your argument? Seriously?
He'd probably get one guy, injure another one.
Yeah, before they take his ass down and beat the shit out of him.
Right.
Look at look what happened at 9/11 with the guys on the plane. They had box cutters. They took them down eventually. I mean, yeah, they all died, and that's tragic. I'm not going to make fun of that, but they stopped them from what their original plan was. Now, if they would have had a gun, it would have been much easier to control that plane.
Right.
You know? So I hate that argument of, well, if you take guns away, it'll be something else. Yes, but come on. I know you're pushing the I know you're pushing the NRA's line, but do you really think that? We all looked at Mike.
Yeah. No, you're right. And like,
put your America hat back on.
I only looked at Mike because he's sitting straight across from me. And you stopped talking.
Sometimes I do that.
It is very true. And that's the thing, too. And I think it's people also buy guns, and that's why there's a flood of firearms on the market because of that fear and that need of escalation.
You want that protection.
You want protection. Where most people forget too, like if you're talking about guns, capacities, and all that, a simple Remington 870 shotgun, you can get it. It's just an 8-round shotgun. Hey, I'm plugging Remington. Do we get money for that?
No. We've been plugging shit since we started and never got a single. Well, we got free pizza from Little Caesars.
That's true.
Little Caesars.
Except Little Caesars, we got free pizza from Little Caesars before they ever plugged us.
And not
or
only that,
we ever plugged them, rather.
I'd say, when they plug us, Jesse. Plus, they give us cold-ass pizzas.
That's true. There wasn't good pizza.
But, when people say home defense, that is an ideal thing for home defense. You don't need a high capacity. Handguns are nice for home defense because you're thinking of, range. Most any incident with a firearm is going to happen usually within, everybody says, 8 yards. There's not that much space.
Yeah, you're not sniping people from across the way.
No.
And you don't need a sniper rifle in your bedroom.
No.
Folks. But even home defense, the argument for home defense, I almost said recent events have shot holes in that theory, but that's kind of a bad way to say that.
How topical.
Kind of topical. There was and I have to go back to my old Blogzilla 1985 article, but there were at least two instances. One I remember specifically where an African-American woman wrecked her car, went to the guy's house, knocked on his door to get help. He shot her through the door with his gun, didn't even look at her, shot her, killed her.
Mm-hmm.
He went to jail for it, as he should.
Same kind of thing. There was a drunk college student. She went to the house next door and couldn't get her key to work. So she starts just pounding on it, trying to wake up her roommate. not realizing that it's like a 45-year-old man who say exact same thing, thinks his house is being broken into.
Yeah.
And shoots through the door and kills her.
There was an old woman in, I forget which state it was, guy walks into the store to rob it, and before he can do anything, she pulls a gun out and shoots him. Everyone said, "You're a hero." I didn't think she was a hero. Yeah, she stopped a robbery, but
she ended a life.
She killed a person.
But robbing a store is not something that, if gone to court and proven guilty, he would not have gotten the death penalty.
No, he would have gotten year, depending on what he tried to steal.
It's funny to me that, like, in a lot of cases, like in the Michael Brown case, maybe not Trayvon Martin, but definitely Michael Brown, maybe Trayvon Martin, where they say that what they did, they may have done bad things. Like Michael Brown was allegedly robbed the store before the incident happened, that they were not death penalty things.
I thought that was completely confirmed. He did rob the store before.
And he was also,
there was a guy on video they said looked like him, but they still argued that it wasn't him.
Well, and if accounts play out like accounts were said, he was going for the officer's gun. Now, I can sit that at that point, if he's going for, if you're an officer and he's going for your weapon, he plans on using it. That changes a lot of things.
That's true. Oh, man, you should have been around for the first few episodes we did of this, because we argued about that. Mr. Blue. We argued about that nonstop.
Okay.
But my argument would be that those cases were not punishable by death.
Exactly, right.
Well, neither was this guy that robbed the store. He didn't harm anybody.
Unless he had a gun and had the possible intent to.
Yeah, but
there's a lot of what-ifs.
It's exactly. This isn't fucking Minority Report. You can't kill a criminal before he's done anything.
Right.
Just because he has the possibility to do it doesn't give you the right to kill him before he does.
Yeah, and I mean, though, to be fair, I have seen, like, there's a lot of material out there, and stuff they show at police academies of, like, what can happen, and that's really what gets a lot of these police officers scared, and honestly, in a lot of cases, they should be. I saw one particularly graphic one that I thought I sent you, maybe I didn't. A couple of weeks ago, of this woman at a routine traffic stop. She pulls the guy out and, basically she's just talking. She turns away for a second and he just beats the shit out of her.
Yeah.
And she didn't recover.
Yeah. And
he just drove away.
Mm-hmm.
But with a case like that of should they be armed and should they take action? Yeah. But you know what she is? She's a cop, right?
Yeah.
She's a police officer. Police officers should have guns. They should have the guns.
Well, I know, but I mean, that's what we were arguing a second ago with Mike Brown. Like, you were talking about, like, they shouldn't have the right to shoot them because...
Well, there's a difference between, I think you guys are kind of miscommunicating in that, like...
Wouldn't be the first time.
There's a very clear line that, or maybe not necessarily a clear line, but there is a line of when that lethal force is justified.
Right.
And that line is, it's if... It is to stop lethal force against yourself or against a civilian.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so that's where that, it's not, you know, they're not going to just come in here, you know, if someone calls the police here because, you know, someone's causing a stink, they don't come in guns blazing, just shoot first person they see.
Otherwise, Dave Mahoney would be dead right now.
Yes, that's true.
He may be dead right now. I don't know,
who
actually.
Knows? We haven't seen him or heard from him in a while.
Yeah.
Especially with that, like, the older lady talking, it's like, it brings up that argument, well, none of this would have happened if everyone there was armed. It's like,
and they said that about the reporters too. If they, and I swear,
that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah.
Fawn Riggin. Do you guys know who Fawn Riggin is?
Yeah.
She apparently posted after the incident on her Facebook that if they had been armed, this wouldn't happen. See why we need more guns. What a ridiculous statement.
Yeah, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. Like, no amount of them being armed was going to stop that.
No,
from happening.
That guy got the drop on him. He put bullets in. Yeah, situational awareness. He had the high ground. He took them out before they even knew what was happening.
Right.
Well, and even
because she was in full on reporter mode, she wasn't not paying even attention. Paying attention.
Yeah. And like the theater shooting that he just got
Holmes.
Just got
8,000 years.
8,
000,
that.
But so. Like, someone's like, oh,
what's the fucking point?
If someone in the theater, had a gun, then that could have been stopped. Really? You don't think that that would have just been a crossfire and civilians would have gotten in there? One of the things where you go, like, if I go to Walmart right now, buy a gun, they go through my background check and all that, and then if they just, here you go. What needs to happen is just, like, if every gun sale needs to be accompanied with something along the lines of a concealed carry, where you have to go through,
you have to earn the right to have the gun.
Exactly.
Under safety class. That's what everybody, I always say.
Yeah, I always thought that you had to have, like, hunter safety, like, you had to have taken that course in order to purchase a gun. I thought that for a long time. I'm very wrong.
Yeah. How about a mental evaluation? Not just a mental background check, but how about a mental evaluation? you know, for to buy a gun. Because it's not like you're buying groceries and it's not a big deal. Guns are a big deal.
Right.
To a lot of people like us, we're normal guys. Hey, we're American Joes. We like guns. We see them as fun activities and no big thing. We're not going to go kill anybody. But for people that kill people, it is a big thing. It is a life-ending thing.
Oh, no. Even to us, I feel like everyone here who has handled a gun knows that it's not just a fun thing. You are always... If you're not, you are doing it fucking wrong.
There's gun fundamentals that, like, if you go to a range, everybody should be practicing
the basic fundamentals.
The first time I got invited to go shooting was with a friend of mine and his dad. And it was not until I could recite the Holland family gun laws was I able to even go near a gun.
Mm-hmm.
Which is, every gun is loaded.
Yes.
You do not point the gun at anything that you do not want to die.
Exactly.
If you point the gun at something, that is going to die. And, like, it's just, you have to...
And that's all, like, control, basic finger, stuff finger. You get in, like, the Hunter Ed course that, like, Mike was talking about. I took it when I was younger. And, yeah, that's the... They said that so many times throughout the day. Like, I can still see all the pictures they kept posting all over everything. Every gun is loaded. Like, they could not stress that point enough.
It could be disassembled in front of you, and the only bullets you own are in the cabinet in the next room. That gun is loaded.
It is loaded.
And now, back to the theater shooting for a second. There was another incident where you talk about if they had had a gun. There was an older gentleman sitting in the theater. This happened not long after the Holmes thing. And I don't remember his name, but... Guy behind him, they get in an argument, throws popcorn at him, the guy gets up and shoots him. Stands up, pulls his pistol out, shoots the guy dead, sits back down and waits for the cops. God. Thought he was justified.
What the fuck?
Thought he was justified. Anybody that has a gun that feels justified in their actions can kill and destroy lives so easily. And you think that doesn't, and the NRA would say that doesn't need to change. There doesn't need to be anything that changes with this. Everything's fine.
That guy was arrested, right?
Like, oh, yeah, he was definitely arrested. Okay. He's in jail for it. But doesn't change the fact that the guy's dead.
Well, yeah.
You know?
I'm just making sure that
like, he didn't get off.
Yeah, there wasn't something like the NRA came swooping in like, well, he was assaulted by salty treats.
No.
Salty treats.
But, like, and I know...
There was a great article. Hold on. Let me find this thing on Funny or Die real quick. Did you guys see the Funny or Die... The Funny or Die NRA statement. Let me find this for you real quick. Yeah, it's a blank statement for the NRA that just says, oh God, let me find it. Talk amongst yourselves for a second. I can't entertain you guys all the time.
I can't talk about things.
Words.
What things?
Salty treats. Salty treats. That was funny, right, guys? Oh God.
Guys, I need an adult.
Remember when we talked about salty treats?
That's why you can never leave, Shannon. The show just falls apart. We need you.
Well, you're lucky because I can't find it. Oh, wait, I found it.
I'm excited. Waiting with beta.
I don't even know what you were looking for. I'll be honest with you.
I saw this on Facebook a couple days ago, and it's great. I mean, it's not funny, but it's funny. It's a blank. It's a fill-in-the-blank response to let people know you're pro-guns after a mass shooting. And I'm just going to read it just real quick. It basically says directions fill in the blanks, post on all social media outlets for up to 3 days after the shooting, and then promptly forget about that shooting that had ever occurred. I'm going to post it on our Facebook, but it basically says earlier today, insert number of people were shot and insert number of people were killed at location, must be within the United States, by a gunman. Uh-huh. This news is, choose one, tragic, devastating, horrific. Today we mourn the loss of these number of dead people. Name of deceased was a nice adjective, respected occupation or homemaker who was loved by his, her family and community. Note, repeat previous statement for each deceased person as needed, taking care to use different adjectives to describe each person. And then below it says, now is not the time to talk about guns. Here are the reasons why. It is too soon to discuss gun rights. We are still mourning the loss of these people. Do not politicize this sad, heartbreaking situation. Guns don't kill people. People kill people. Gun ownership is a part of American culture and is protected by the United States Constitution. The only thing that can stop a bad guy with a gun is a good guy with a gun. Criminals will always find a way to get guns no matter what measures we take, so what's the point? Hyperviolent media and video games are at fault.
Oh, no.
We need to deal with mental health in this country.
Oh, we talk.
Cars are more dangerous than guns. If someone was determined enough, they could kill someone with a spoon. Should we outlaw spoons, too? And it goes on and on. And it's done in satire, of course.
See, but it's done in satire, but there are people that legitimately
will read that and say, that's legit, because they've used that so many times.
Well, yeah.
Because honestly, I thought that you were reciting something from Fox News.
I'll be real. Where's Moran?
Moran, the news
Moran
fox.
Moran, the news fox. Is he here somewhere?
Oh, hey, everybody.
Moran! What the hell? I thought you were watching the My Little Pony marathon.
Oh.
Giving yourself a squeezy.
Oh, no. Well, I couldn't afford the huggy squeezy.
The huggy squeezy. He upgraded. Yeah, so don't blame guns, guys. I'll tell you what we do blame. Saw this. Congressman, what's his name? Congressman Pete Sessions, Republican out of Texas. Republican. Go figure.
Out of Texas.
Out of Texas.
Texas. About guns?
About guns?
Buy a bottle of Jack Daniels, get a free gun.
He was on a radio show, and he basically said that the reason, the cause of the gun violence in America is because of diversity.
Okay, let's...
Diversity.
I'm intrigued.
So,
I'll bite.
Please tell me that expands, and it's not just him basically saying it's the brown people.
No, no, no. He's basically
that's what it sounds like.
He's basically saying that, unlike societies like Asian societies, where they have a like-minded system, that the diversity in America is what's causing us to have so much civil unrest, and that's why we're going against each other, and that we all need to think one way. So that's the real cause. Is
so
you people are too diverse.
So he is referring to diverse cultures as opposed to...
Not just color. No.
Okay.
I don't think this is a racial thing. I think, well, it's a bullshit thing.
That kind of sounds like...
Yeah.
That sounds like a very thinly veiled
racist
thing.
That sounds like he said like that thing is like, oh, God, that was really racist. I mean, we think different, and we need to think not different.
This is how it actually played out. It's 11:30 p.m., He's on his like fourth scotch of the night, and his aide is like, "Sir, we really need to get this press conference. We really need to get your statement out there. Listen, Chinese people are all in China. They don't kill each other. If we just put all the white people in America, we won't kill each other." And the aide's like, "Oh God, he's passed out. Okay, it's diversity is a problem. That's what we're gonna go with."
I want to give a update to our fans out there that Nate Smith just saw the Muslims don't like Super Smash Brothers.
What's
comment.
The,
he replied, "Fuck off, Shannon. I do not hate Muslims, dickwad."
All of the eloquence and grace we would come to expect.
Yes. Did he ever listen to the last show that we like really made fun of him on, that we were really worried that he was going to share the link to our page?
The one where Johnny called him a little prick. Yeah, he did listen to that. And he said that his opinion matters just as much as anyone else's, no matter how sheltered he is. Asa, stop. I'm looking at you specifically.
No, Asa is actually in an attempt to not do what you're thinking he wants to do. I think Asa is distracting himself.
Yeah.
I mean,
he's not wrong. He is entitled to his opinion. Certain opinions he's held that we have talked about are clearly not.
In disagreement.
Are in disagreement.
That's the nicest way to put it. We don't have to point out how terrible his thoughts and processes are.
Everyone has opinions, even if they're not good.
Exactly. Opinions are like guns. Everyone's got them, and they're not
assholes.
Afraid to
and
kill
never,
you with
and
them.
They're never used, and they're never used badly. Wait.
Hold on.
Yeah. So, in the argument for and against gun violence, we've come up with nothing.
And that's actually a really good point, though. There is, I can't think of a good answer, and I don't.
No,
it's
and
not
because
even,
it's such a complicated. There's so many.
Yeah, there's no real right or wrong.
There's the like you guys were talking about the gun buyback programs that they might be able to do, but
they don't.
The
guns work.
They really don't. No. Look at Chicago. There's, I mean, my gosh.
There's nothing truly. It just kind of seems like nothing that's been presented right now is truly effective or really a viable option.
There is one cool thing. Like people are doing stuff with guns with new technology, like built-in fingerprint scanners on firearms. So the firearm could only be used like with a thumbprint scanner.
Mm-hmm. Is that what they did with RoboCop?
Yeah.
Well, no, maybe.
Judge Dredd?
Judge Dredd.
Which one?
All of them.
The newer one.
Stallone or Dredd?
The good one.
But
Stallone?
But like if we did law enforcement with fingerprint scanners, I could have a long thing about that. It's a cool idea.
It's a cool idea, but it's not going to stop gun violence.
No, it's not. But the idea also being though, like, registration, that would be, this gun would be registered to me, to my fingerprint.
Yeah.
And then, so you could say, either through databases or through background checks, rigorous things that, like.
Until the phone, like, cell phones can actually get that right, I wouldn't put a whole lot of.
Well, mine does okay.
But people can still, like, but if I steal your phone, I can still, like, find a way to.
You can hack.
Yeah.
But it's still not gonna stop people from killing people.
No.
Right.
Yeah. You know, it just means that the cops can find you easier.
Because, I mean, right. You've gotta go again, like, the most recent shooting. Yeah. Like, outside of depression, did that guy have any other actual mental issues?
The Bryce Williams?
Yeah.
They talked about, like, I mean, anger problems.
Yeah,
he had
bad anger issues, and he had been bullied since he was a child. He was gay and black, and said that he had been bullied for that for a long, long time. But he blamed everybody for racism. He made a lot of excuses.
Right. But again, there's not really any, like, he didn't have any actual, like.
No history of violence or anything like that.
I thought.
Right. Well, so.
I might be getting him backwards, but didn't he get, like, wasn't the reason he was fired from that job because of some sort of, like, anger outburst type deal?
Yes, yeah. But not violent outbursts. Okay. Like, he had problems communicating with people. Right. And, but he never, as far as I know, never got physically violent.
So, okay. Like, there's nothing that, basically, nothing that he had done in his entire life, like, or any kind of, like, mental assessment would have kept him from buying
even a
fingerprint registered gun.
Right. He still would have passed it and he still could have carried
it. Still would have carried it. This tragedy still would have happened.
I think, and you're going to think I'm crazy, and maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. Lord knows I usually don't. But when I say we need tougher gun laws, I mean tougher gun laws. Like, I don't know. If you take guns out of the hands of criminals, I mean, how bad would it be if a criminal knew that if he got caught with an unregistered gun that, I don't know, execute him. That's too far, isn't it?
Very too far. Yeah. Well,
but fuck, like, it would send a message, wouldn't it?
But really, I mean, it's like,
Vlad the Impaler got around with that. It worked for him for a long time. Mm-hmm.
You start impaling motherfuckers in front of, in Chicago.
Heads on pikes.
These guys had guns.
Do you want a gun?
No, sir.
Thanks. No.
Wait, dead men tell no tales, so that doesn't work. Sorry.
Well, I want to see that movie, too.
Hmm?
I want to see that movie.
Yeah.
It's Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yeah. And then
hey, so go Caribbean. Ahead. You say words now. Oh, the fuck up. What the fuck did you just say?
Caribbean. Guys. Caribbean. This is Gun Show. We can talk about it later.
I'm about to show him the Gun Show. The show's
are they,
coming
are they,
off.
Where are they?
Michael, run.
I'm fast.
It's Caribbean, by the way, for everyone listening. It's Caribbean.
I'm leaning in. I want Caribbean.
So, but you were talking about, like, harsher punishments. The fact that there's still mandatory minimum sentencing for pot in a lot of states.
Right.
But, you know, so-and-so with, like, but aggravated assault can still get you probation.
Yeah.
That's fucking insane.
Well, there's a guy that is just now getting out of jail after serving 20 years for three possessions. Because the law at the time said three felony possessions is
20, mandatory minimum sentencing. It's part of the war on drugs, which failed horribly.
Yes.
And has done nothing but lead to overcrowding, which is a whole nother show.
Yeah.
But if you're going to implement that kind of sentencing, that just broad, oh, you did a thing, fuck you, the end. Don't you think it should be on something way more serious?
Than marijuana?
Yes,
maybe, absolutely.
Maybe on unregistered firearms or something that can actively kill someone.
Most criminals that have, the street criminals, the guys you don't see on TV, because there's two levels of criminals that shoot people in America. And you guys, if you disagree with me, let me know. There are the kinds that do it in a spectacle way, like Bryce Williams, that have the registered guns and murder people that quote unquote matter. And then there's the street criminals, like in Chicago, who I believe there was a little girl a couple of weeks ago, maybe a month ago, that passed away from a bullet. I think she was 7. She was gunned down in Chicago. No one knows or cares who shot her. It doesn't matter.
You're not thinking about the St. Louis one, are you?
No, there was another one. I am thinking about the St. Louis one too, but there was, I mean, okay. Jesus Christ, this happens all the time. That's the sad thing. Part. Yeah, but like, no one cares about them. Those guns, you think those were registered guns that shot those little kids? No. It's some street criminal that bought an unregistered gun.
Or stole it,
and they're using them, as opposed to this guy who shot 2 people on camera and had a legal gun.
Mm-hmm.
So there's 2 kinds of criminals, the ones we care about and the ones we don't.
Well, I mean,
my point on it, but it really pisses me off.
Well, it's just because, I mean, he did it live on camera, so it was one of those things, like, the media was able to really show it off, because
obviously, and that's what they do.
Is
really show
footage
off.
Of it.
And to be fair, in defense of the media, they were white, the ones that died on camera. They weren't black children. They were important people.
So, but again, there was footage of those people.
That was satire.
I know that was satire. Oh, yeah. But in, like, actual defense of the media, like, that was filmed.
It was on camera.
That was on camera, and that could easily be, like, thrown around.
Well, you saw, I think it was New York Post and New York Times that ran the cover photo. three photos of the shooting, of him pulling the gun and the girl turning. They ran that as the cover and got in a huge amount of trouble with it, said you shouldn't show these things. Bullshit. You should show those things.
That way people can actually get, like, an idea. And you've said this before, and I agree with it. Like, you show that stuff so that people can get an idea. Like, this is what this looks like.
This is the reality. This is what happens. Mm-hmm. That's why I go to Live Leak. This is the reality of what happens. This is what it looks like when people die.
Well, and to me, that's kind of why I avoid, like, because I actively avoided watching it. Like, I saw it when it popped up on Reddit. I saw it when it was shared on Facebook. But because I know that. Like, I already know that the world is shit and everyone hates each other and we're all just going to burn up this entire planet.
We're going to murder each other someday.
I don't need to necessarily see it actually happen because I know it's there. Now, granted, I'm sure there are people that are like, this is news to them. And that must be nice. But
I'm pointing at Lindsay. She avoids things like this, like the plague. And I'm not saying anything bad about her. It's not an insult. She's behind me right now. She can smack me.
And she stuck out her tongue at you. It was her reaction.
But she's the kind of person, and like, let's say Krista Francis, Stephen Bright, guys that we know and care about, the smart people, that avoid these things because they don't want to see that side of life. And that's the people that got upset at the New York article, was they didn't want to see that this is what it looks like when before people die. But you need to see these things, because if you don't know this is happening, then you can't change anything. You can't bury your head in the sand and go, there's no problem, there's no problem.
Because you really
Metal
don't.
Gear came out today. This is fantastic. No, there is a problem, and it needs to be addressed.
You're right. And like I work at a medical facility, but I don't work in the medical field.
Do not say where it is.
I don't. I'm
sir,
not. I'm not saying.
Refrain from saying jobs here.
Yeah, I'm leaving it at that, though.
Okay.
But I have...
You've seen these things.
Aftermath.
Yeah.
And that's a very scary thing. And you're right. And it's been within the past 2.5 years that I've been doing this that my eyes have really been open to some of these things. And that, but weirdly enough, that doesn't change some of my things like gun ownership, even though I see what happens to things like that because I know I'm a responsible owner.
That's what I was just about to say. You're a responsible owner, and you have a respect for the laws and the rules.
Exactly.
But look at
it's
guys.
That lack of respect.
And yeah. Look at the guys that did, you know, the Columbine shooting. Was it Eric, Dylan Klebold and Eric, I forget their names.
Good.
Okay,
good.
Yeah, exactly. Good. The jackasses that shot the school at Columbine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The only thing they knew about gun violence was Doom. That was what they played. And I'm not blaming Doom.
Well, that's
I actually
they,
wrote in defense
that's,
of Doom.
That's what they say. That's just, they
well, at the time
knew
though,
that...
there was no Live Leak. There weren't sites like that that you could see that
I mean,
kind
yeah,
of stuff,
YouTube
you know?
Wasn't even a thing then.
No, literally.
Yeah.
Literally, YouTube wasn't a thing. So these guys had no real life experience with the effects of murder. And plus, there had been no school shootings at the time that we had heard of. So it wasn't like they were copycats.
That was the first one that got really publicized.
Yeah.
Right.
So they did what they did without the knowledge of the ramifications of their actions, I think. You know?
Right.
Whereas now, we know what happens. And it's even worse than it was then.
Well, yeah, it's because... like. Kids get to that situation, you know, they get pushed to that point where they just don't care.
Yeah.
And they're like, you know, everybody would be better off without me, but you know what, I'm going to take a couple of the assholes that have made my life hell down with me.
And am I the only one that was afraid Nate Smith would walk down that path someday? Does he strike you that way? No, that's a joke. Nate, swear to God, buddy, that's a joke. That was a joke. Okay. Clarification.
Now, there are people that come in here, though, that I do feel...
Oh, yeah, the people that are so bloodthirsty when they play video games...
And there's some people that I do legitimately fear. They're going to, like, if we pick on them too much, which fortunately we don't really do to their face.
so it's
boy,
fine.
Boy, that makes us sound horrible.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Come on into the store where we'll talk shit about
you. Don't associate me with that. I don't make fun of people. I'm just here for the show.
He just shoots people.
No.
See, but Mike likes to go out and shoot cans.
Yeah.
Africans.
Oh, no. I walked right into that.
Hook, line, and sinker.
Yeah. But yeah, so, I mean, there are people that come in here that I legitimately feel like I don't think that we would be their first target.
if I'm going to throw that out there.
They'd
save us for last.
Yeah, if they, like, we'd be last on the spot, like, if they were able, it's like, you know what? And if I've got time, I'm going to stop by Game of Grounds.
Just walking around with their gun. Oh, Mr. Shannon.
I've got to put that spin on it. Was the Dane Cook joke? Did you give him a Snickers before? Thanks for the candy.
We don't have Snickers. But we do have the great new vending machine.
With Surge.
709 Broadway.
Give them a Surge.
Buy them a Surge.
All right, get your Surge on.
Here you go, buddy.
I'll get you a Surge. Just please don't shoot me. Like, well, I could shoot you and then take money and then get Surge.
That's not how it works.
No.
That's not how it works.
Oh, well.
You know, the people, those right-wing crazy people, because they're right-wing. They're not left-wing. They're right-wing.
Yeah,
sorry, Mike.
It's
how do you know I'm right-wing?
I don't. I just got that red shirt on.
It's Deadpool.
Deadpool would be a hardcore conservative just because he would think it's hilarious.
Yeah. But a lot of those people, you know, after Sandy Hook, they actually said Sandy Hook didn't happen. These people legitimately believe that it was fake, just to push Obama's agenda for gun control.
Because there was a photo, there was a bullshit Facebook post that went viral that everyone's, you know, great aunt sent to him because someone just copied a picture of someone who died at the theater. I think it was the theater shooting because it was whatever the previous giant shooting was.
Yeah.
And then they took a picture of her and added it to a news report of the Sandy Hook and like, well, how did this?
Same person.
It's the same person. They're just lying to you. They didn't think anyone would catch that. So people were using that to say that Sandy Hook never happened. And if you hold that belief, if that is your opinion that Sandy Hook didn't happen, you can just go fuck yourself so hard.
I mean, do those people also read The Onion and assume it's
real?
Probably.
Legit? Yeah. Like, I would say, you know, go tell the parents and the families of those kids that died, go tell them that it was all a ruse by Obama.
But we're still saying these are probably also the same people that think, like, the 9/11 airplanes were all empty. People believe things like
that.
Or that
jet fuel doesn't melt steel.
Or that the Pentagon bomb, the plane that went to the Pentagon was actually a bomb.
Right.
It was a missile that hit it. And I'm a conspiracy theorist. That's what we base Tanner Thursday on, is the fact that Tanner and I are both conspiracy theorists. And even I am not so stupid as to think that a shooting at a kid's school was fabricated by the United States government to push an agenda that they've never pushed.
And that then, like, so clearly, like, I don't understand how someone could say Sandy Hook was set up so Obama could take our guns. Then why didn't it work?
Yeah, why do you still have guns?
Why did they go through it? And literally nothing has changed.
And as soon as
there's not even been legislation pushed through.
No. And as soon as Alison Parker and Adam Ward died, everyone again, well, now Obama's going to use this to take your guns. In 7 years, he hasn't taken them yet, has he, Redneck?
He hasn't done it in the last 4 mass shootings that we've had.
Last week.
Oh, my
last
God.
Fucking week.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I mean, like, and with all of the quote radical things that he's done in the past, like, year, 2 years, do you really think if he wanted to take your guns away, that wouldn't have been one of the big things he was pushing?
Well, they said they were getting a force ready down in, I think, Texas, wasn't it? To march in and start taking people's guns. People literally believed that they were getting military ready to do that.
There was something
I forget the name of it. A certain owner's father also believed that.
Didn't, like, Texas assemble a group of, like, people or soldiers or something like that to stop Obama from coming in and taking their guns?
No, there was I don't know if they, this might be a different thing, but in Texas.
You're talking about the ranch owner, aren't you?
There was a, just a normal military training exercise that was taking place in just, like, the desert of Texas. And people were sharing and posting on Facebook that this was a martial law test run.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And that the military was taking over these, like, square miles to promote martial law, and that was going to go nationwide.
Yes.
And part of that was they were going to start going through and collecting everyone's guns.
Which is ridiculous.
We're
absolutely ridiculous.
Wasn't that, like,
how crazy do you have to be to believe that? It's people like Ann Coulter and Glenn Beck and people like that that push this radical right-wing agenda that people that support Donald Trump just eat the fuck up and go, this must be true because I don't like Obama, but it's not because he's black.
Barack Hussein.
He renamed that mountain.
Mount McKinley.
Did you know that Denali is actually Muslim for socialism?
Actually, he was promoting GMC Motors and the GMC Denali. But
did you ever hear the irony with the whole Texas thing?
I think of Texas, I just start laughing in general. What a bunch of fucktards.
Yeah, like, okay, so after that whole
you have a big state full of people angry.
The only thing you gave us was Michael Irvin and King of the Hill.
I mean, King of the Hill. Let's be
King
fair.
Of the Hill alone.
Worth
all of their redneckness.
Yeah.
Shortly after that whole thing happened, and they made sure that the martial law folk left. That's when they called on the National Guard to help with all the flooding that was happening. Yeah.
These people are they're the kind of people that make the people that wear tinfoil hats and talk about aliens coming back, make them look normal and smart.
Well, we're kind of hitting a weird point here, though. I mean, we kind of hit, like, I always go back to Idiocracy, where there is a very, very true point when that movie's becoming a documentary. But...
Great movie, by the way. Terry Crews was in it.
Hilarious.
Yeah. As president, what was it?
Oh, like President Hector Mondo? Macho? No, Mondo was the name of the...
Of the drink.
Brondo. One.
Brondo?
I love Terry Crews.
Here we've got, two weird classes. We talk about the criminals that are arming themselves. We also have these extreme people that will believe anything.
Yeah.
I mean, there's extremes on both sides.
There are. There are extremes on all sides.
Right. Yeah.
Everything has extremists.
There are people that will fall for anything. And when these people start getting guns, then we're in trouble.
And they already have them. Yeah.
And they are higher caliber and faster firing than anything we can get.
Yeah.
But I joke about the Barack Hussein Obama thing, but I know real people in my life
that believe that way. Yeah.
That all legislation that Obama has pushed has been, for the Muslims.
I know a certain owner's dad who truly believes that Obama is from Kenya and has told me that multiple times. Donald Trump actually spearheaded the initiative to get Obama to release his birth record.
Show
me the birth certificate, because he didn't believe Obama was from America. I can't think of another president they've ever said that about, except the one black one. That's funny, isn't
it? With the funny name.
With the funny name, because this is a Christian country, and you better be a Christian president.
I mean, if his name...
And Obama's Christian! That's the funny part!
And had been a member of a Christian church long before he became president.
Yeah, but that pastor was crazy.
Okay, he was a little crazy.
Yeah, no, that's entirely fair.
Even Obama was like, whoop, gotta go.
That's one of those things like, oh shit, damn it.
I backed the wrong pony on that one. And guys, again, if you haven't watched the John Oliver televangelist episode, go back and watch it, because it's really fantastic.
It is really, really good and informative.
Yeah. As he often
is.
And
infuriating.
Yeah, as it often is. Well, also, I want to point out, I thought about that today. I was like, man, John Oliver's really good. I wish I were that good. He also writes his shows. He has dialogue that is written.
He's also a really good stand-up comic.
He is. I mean, he was on The Daily Show. He's a funny guy. But I just want to point out, the Podzilla 1985, this is all off the cuff. No scripts. Nothing.
Yeah, we might do a little bit of research ahead of time, but
I wrote down...
That's
true.
Yeah. I wrote down 7 words that I didn't say tonight.
Without any context, I want you to say those 7 words. Just the words. No context.
Jerry Michalek, reload speed, guns and knives.
Well.
Yep. I had counterpoints that I was like, I can't forget to say these. Because if we talked about gun capacity, I'm just going to, my quick points. This guy is not human. He can fire 12 rounds out of a revolver, 6 shots, reload, 6 shots. In under 2 seconds. So a person can practice. That was going to be my argument there. If you've got the drive, you can do stuff like that.
But. I mostly just sat over here and drew the 3 panelists naked.
Hey, look, everybody. It's the Cookie Monster.
Cookie.
Local references get local work.
We should start a fan club and call it The Loop. And people have to buy to be put in the loop.
Yes, so they can hear the inside jokes.
I started a Facebook group years ago called The Rumor Mill. You remember The Rumor Mill?
I remember The Rumor Mill.
Oh, my God. It was so great. People would just go in there and post random things about people they heard.
Most of it was just completely, made up.
It was just complete nonsense, but it was hilarious.
It was really funny.
We made fun of Mimi a lot on there. She was like the Nate of the time.
That's pretty true.
Her Wii fell out in the pool once.
That's accurate. What? That happened.
Lindsay's probably not.
Lindsay's dying.
Wait. That happened, or the fact that got posted happened?
Both. Yeah. That wasn't a rumor, guys. All right. We're going to wrap this up. I loved it. Informative talk, some opinions, some jokes. Feel good event of the year. IGN gave it a 4 out of 10. Not enough water. That's still relevant, right?
I still take issue with that because they're not wrong.
There was literally no water in this. Everyone's drinking soda. Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah.
Well, no, technically, he was drinking tea.
Yeah.
There's water in that. There's water in that.
Yeah.
All right. Well, in that case, I want to thank Asa, Jesse, and Michael for appearing, Mike, especially, your first time on the show.
Thanks for having me.
How was it compared to Multipixel when you guys were doing video game reviews?
I mean, I've got to look at people instead of a screen.
He doesn't know what to do with his hands.
I don't.
Just don't do what Kurt McDowell did and just play drums on the table.
That's kind of true. He's straight up playing bongos the whole time.
I had to put my hands like over here. I was holding the chair to keep myself from drumming.
It takes
and doing
you get used to. It takes you. You'll get it.
That's why I had the twist tie. I can just.
And I mean,
Lindsay plays games on her iPad.
And Kurt, if you're listening, like you're not the first person that's ever had that problem.
Oh no, Kurt, you did fine. Yeah, everybody does fine on this show.
I remember the Stephanie, her first appearance on Pentanerd back in the day. You guys are looking at me confused. It was a podcast that. Never mind. She had.
I'll look it up later. Good luck. See if it's there.
She had a bracelet, and she was doing the Kurt thing. And not only were her long fingernails hitting the table, but the bracelet was too. So it's like chank, 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 chank. Oh, it was bad. It was real bad.
I'm going to edit that.
No, please don't.
And I'm going to say, please don't. I'm going to say, hey Jesse, what's your Asian friend's name?
Because I knew exactly where you're going to go as soon as you said I'm going to edit.
Lindsay made that joke once.
Uh-oh.
Is she there?
Oh, you're getting hand symbols? None of them are good?
We're coming, I mean, one last story I'll leave you guys with. Asa, keep her away from me. So we're coming out of Best Buy.
No, Lindsay, stop.
We're coming out of Best Buy. Her purse is making a noise, and this Asian guy walks by at the same time, and she makes a reference that her purse keeps going ching, 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 ching. And I fall to the floor laughing.
Well, that's not her making. The way you set that up is that Lindsay made a terrible joke.
No.
When in reality, she just made an unfortunate timed comment.
She is voting for Donald Trump, though.
I mean,
who
isn't?
She's nodding her head. Yes.
I mean, so that just means that she cares about America's future and getting it back to its roots.
Get out of here, Mexico. All right.
On that note,
for Asa Gray, Jesse Kimball, Mike Branum, all of which will lose their jobs soon.
Yay!
thank you guys for listening. Jesse, do you got Marvelous Chris and Jesse for tomorrow?
Yeah.
Or what's the deal?
It'll be up tomorrow.
It'll be tomorrow.
It's now a bi-weekly show. I don't know if I actually told you about that.
I think you did. I think you did.
I want to say so. And yeah, like so. Posting it tomorrow, we recorded it last week, and then next week we'll record for the following week's posting.
And if you wanted to talk about the elderly, you should have called 2 weeks ago when we were talking about no one ever gets that reference.
Please, someone watch Mr. Show so Shannon can have someone to talk to.
Asa?
Watch Rick and Morty.
I did before I came in.
Good.
I really did, and I watched Doc and Morty. Doc and
Don't
Marty.
Don't watch Doc and Marty.
I did.
Don't watch Doc and Marty.
Who made you watch Doc and Marty?
CJ, and then I made Katie and Bob watch it.
Oh.
A lot of ball licking.
A lot of ball licking.
Steven made me watch it today.
Yeah.
And there was a tuggy squeezy at the end.
That's what I heard. I was fortunately closing the register at that point. I didn't get to see that.
Just the regular Rick and Morty's great.
And on that note, ladies and gentlemen.
Wubba lubba dub dub.
Another Podzilla in the books. Thank you so much. We'll see you tomorrow for the Marvelous Chrissy for the comic show. We'll see you then. Have a good night.